Let's discuss superelastic collisions. We can state collisions in which coefficient of restitution is more than 1 are termed as superelastic collisions. And as we know, when E is equals to 1, a collision is elastic, and we can state no dissipation of energy takes place in deformation at the time of collision. And whenever E is less than 1, this gives some energy loss takes place. And when E is equals to 0, we state the energy loss is maximum. So, we can state as the value of E increases and approaches E equals to 1, that is a stage where no loss of energy takes place, or kinetic energy of the bodies before collision and after collision would be equal. So, with this analogy, we can state that when E is more than 1, this implies gain of energy. So, whenever the coefficient of restitution in a state is more than 1, always during collision some energy gain will take place. So, we can state kinetic energy after collision of bodies will be more than kinetic energy before collision. As we have studied in case of elastic collision, at the time of maximum deformation, kinetic energy is stored in form of potential energy, which is maximum at the time of maximum deformation. And later on, it is completely released, because of which final kinetic energy is equal to initial kinetic energy. So, we can state E more than 1 happens only when in a collision some energy is released. Unless some energy is released, final kinetic energy can never be more than initial kinetic energy. So, final kinetic energy is more than initial, that means during the collision some energy is released. Like we can simply state like the cases of explosion. In cases of explosion, we can state some internal energy of physical bodies is released in form of kinetic energy of the fragment of the body. So, we can state after collision, whenever we talk about an explosion, the velocity of separation of particles will be more than velocity of approach. Because when a single body explodes, velocity of approach is zero, only particles separate away from each other. So, we have just taken an overview of superelastic collision for your knowledge. So, just keep the phenomena of superelastic collision and the correlation with the coefficient of restitution. This is quite useful in future for you.